score to keep it going, or the Penguins will get a shootout victory.
Over to Marino, resets. John Marino, shadowed by Orlov all the way to the top. Marino forced to center and dishes for Gensel. Crosby stays out there. Gensel, self-pass, has it now in the circle. Up high, Letanga blast, stop, rebound, score! Sidney Crosby! It's curtains for the Caps, OT winner for the black and gold.
Well, that was digging down deep as a team, sticking with your goaltender, saying, the guys that started the game are going to be the guys. We're going to keep you together. We're going to play the goaltender in the second from DeSmith and ending with Crosby. And it distracted me. Maybe it distracted Jari.
Chris Letang, round three. He scores.
Wow.
Bar down on the backhand.
Head up. Fake. Shesterkin. Steve.
Sidney Crosby trying to change that, leaves it for Letang, cuts across, has some space now. Gensel, a drive, he scores! Jake Gensel! Give him 100 goals in his career, it's 3-2.
Wide open, the Penguins enter the zone, and watch where Gensel moves. He moves to the high slot, he just doesn't stand and watch. He slides all the way out, gets himself available, and finds the five hole right through the stick of Shesterkin. And the Penguins have come back here, being down 2-1, and now have the lead.
Low effort, Georgiev put it by him, up the boards, Joseph has it. Now Crosby, Rangers dead tired. Here's Joseph to Crosby, he shoots, he scores! The Penguins held on to the puck. The Rangers wore down. The Penguins come back and win it in overtime, 5-4.
And they could hardly move. Georgiev behind the net. Some miscommunication with D'Angelo. And then that just gave Crosby some time. He waited. And right through the legs. And I think that's one Georgiev wishes he had back. Here it is again. Just goes right through him. And Pittsburgh, as they've done so many times this season, 5 wins this season, all with third period comebacks.
Sidney Crosby, 40%. Skates in against Semyon Varlamov. Backhand, he scores! Crosby!
Crosby got him to lose his balance. Watch Varlamov, he's going to lose his footing. Right here, he loses it and gets frozen. And when you're frozen, that's trouble against 87, and Josh Bailey's going to have one chance to even it up.
Matheson for CeCe, and now Rush. Shot score, Jake Gensel. After the initial attempt was blocked, the Penguins take a 4-2 lead, and they have their first two-goal lead of the season.
A bit of a broken play here as this puck never gets to the net. Watch Vanecek. He thinks it's getting there. He can't locate it, and it's a difficult save after that. But Gensel with the shot mentality. Get it to the net. The fortuitous bounce, and then follow it up. Go back to the net where you shot it from, and Jake Gensel gives the Penguins a two-goal.
If they can keep the puck where it is in the offensive zone. Aston Reese, a pass to Matheson. Slapped wide with a purpose to himself, and he shoots on the rebound, score! Teddy Bluger! And the Penguins lead it 2-0.
When he gets his puck in the back at the point, look, he's asking for the puck. Give me the puck. He's going to shoot it and follow right away. Watch, jump by Bailey, play the puck off the goaltender. And there's a freebie for Bluger. But it was all Matheson. He was the only guy on the ice that knew what the heck was going on.
That was one of the big talking points coming into the season. Penguins looking for more offense from their defense. They move it low to high. Here's Letang. Holding, shooting, scoring! Letang again! And the Penguins lead it 3-2.
Behind the cage, and it's always a good battle. Gensel and Lee, Crosby to Letang. Look at all the bodies. And Gensel, after leaving behind the net, went in front of the net, right there, impeding the vision. And that's twice.
Look, closing, it's Orlov. Orlov fires, that's deflected away. Jari bats it to the boards. Bluger takes it on the run. Bluger looking for an odd man rush. He's got Kapanen with him. Bluger sets, feeds for Kapanen. He scores. Kasperi Kapanen ends it at 1:43.
Had the puck for about a buck 20. So they had control. The Capitals couldn't regain it. And they finish this off on a beautiful two-on-one passing play. Kapanen gets the game winner to the right side of your screen.
Ian Pageau, the other two Islanders out there. Letang sets it up for Crosby, 33 seconds left. Letang, Crosby, and Gensel. It's Letang through the middle, takes a shot, it goes in! A blocked shot, knuckles past Varlamov. It's an overtime winner for Chris Letang, and the Penguins take it 4-3.
Boy, Letang, you talk about Crosby. Letang does a pretty good job on the island. The ice and Letang, plenty of opportunities. Islanders are back. Letang just lets this shot go, and just a knuckleball, and Varlamov just missed. It goes between the five hole, and Varlamov, you can see, was moving to his left, Brendan, as he dropped down, and little knuckleball and fools Varlamov.
The first time the Penguins have a lead is the last second of the hockey game with 26 seconds to go in overtime.
Carter Hart, those are the types of saves that he made on Sunday. And the Flyers' last game against the Buffalo Sabres, he was outstanding. Wrist shot sails in on the rebound, score! Brian Rust in front! And the Penguins too have a 3-1 lead.
Put them on their toes. They push the Flyers D back. They get that easy zone entry. And they get the shot and the rebound with two players in front of Hart. Yeah, Hart's been good, but not good enough. And the Penguins, they've got to their game. And they've got a 3-1 lead here, courtesy of Brian Rust.
And he emerges into Malkin. 2-on-2 with Jared McCann. The drop pass. McCann has Tanev, goes there. Tanev to the goal. Stop on the rebound. Score! Jared McCann slams it home, and the Pens have a 4-3 lead.
Here comes Malkin. Tanev's going to come off the bench. He's got a lot of jump. Look at him come like a rocket. And he gets the shot on Elliott, and he can't prevent the rebound from coming right out in front of the net.
McCann, Rodriguez at 16-13 after Mika Zibanejad scored at 1:18 for the Rangers. Through center ice, Kapanen has a chance all alone. Kasperi Kapanen, he scores! Right over the glove of Georgiev. And bang, bang, the Penguins have a 2-1 lead.
You see right here, everything's fine. There's nothing going on. And then Keandre Miller with a misread. Kapanen's in behind him. And you see the puck ends up in the back of the
Dumoulin, a double clutch. Here's Letang. And he feeds it all the way across. Dumoulin sends it in. Malkin for Kapanen. There he is. He scores!
Just tremendous work here by Malkin to find Kapanen in front, and it's a smart shot by Kapanen. He knows Kincaid's sliding, he puts it back where he comes from, maybe a little help from Adam Fox off the stick.
Jam it back to the blue line, kept in by the Penguins, came out in front, whistled across ice. Now around behind the net, out in front, Gensel scores! Gensel was parked right there, ready to let her rip, and he did, and Pittsburgh again takes the lead.
Second goal on the power play. And he just picks this perfectly. You know, Johansson comes across and you see he get himself tight to that post, but the angle Gensel have, he just left that far side wide open and he just picked it perfectly.
That was an awesome shot. As Lazar bothering from behind, but it came back to the point. Letang keeping it in. Over to Malkin. Cleared it in front, right on the rebound. They score! Finally chopped in by Gensel in front of the net. And Pittsburgh breaks the double goose egg with a 1-0 lead on the power play.
He's
Pittsburgh just coming right down the gut of the ice, throwing that puck to the net, and that's Evgeny Malkin who's driving through that was hauled down by Miller. You see it right there. He's looking for the redirection as he's coming in.
Penguins have defended well lately, just 5 goals against in the previous 4 games. And you know what Boston's all about. First thing you think of with Boston Bruins, goaltending and defense. Jake Gensel with some room, goes to Crosby, one-timer, he scores! Impossible angle goal, the one-timer, Crosby, and it's 2-1.
What do you, put that thing on edge? He had no room. There's the give, a little crisscross, Crosby opens up, here's the shot. No room there. He's already back, but it went over the pad, hit the top of that pad under the glove. And that's
all he picks up. Russ tried to throw it in front, blocked by Severson. Crosby reaching out, diving to the ice. It's jarred back. Now Gensel frees up the puck for Russ, tries to cut in front with it, goes backhand, he scores. What a move by Brian Rust. And the Penguins take the lead.
It's an unbelievable goal and sweet hands going to that right there. He gets inside on Severson. Look at this backhand by Rust. It was a partial 2-on-1, so you see Janssen has to make sure he takes away a pass. As you see Kapanen there.
Moved in. Karski telling his defender to wheel, and now McCann up top. Marino with a bullet, he scores! John Marino!
Matt Irwin, and I think this is why he's not able to get in the position what he wants, but it's a great job by Pittsburgh to forecheck. See how he got tangled up with Irwin there? He's trying to recollect his stick, and in that process, wasn't able to get in the position that he wanted, and in just that split second of losing time allows Marino to get this puck to the net.
Zahorn up behind the goal for Angelo. Centering pass intended for Goudreau. That's broken up. Zahorn, he scores! Radim Zahorn! Welcome to the show. First National Hockey League goal.
The big Czech Republic man. Look at that release. The position. Great forecheck by this line. A nice feed by Angelo, who watched the Buffalo Sabres as a kid. And look how deep. The netminder took
three different goal scorers. Number one power play unit on. Good speed from Gensel off the line on the entry pass. Tipped in by Brian Rust. Gensel winds it back to the top. Letang, McCann in that spot. Right to the middle. Rust. He scores! Brian Rust. Power play goal. 4-0.
Take a look at the Penguins. Everything is perfect here. The entry with speed. You back up everybody. Get it back to the point. Watch this passing play. Around the outside. Touch pass from Crosby. And Gensel. And Rust, head up. Knows exactly where he's going there. And he finds the moving Sorokin in an empty space between his pads. A beautiful shot. Absolutely spectacular power play for the
Penguins. Try and hurry ahead. Jason Zucker for McCann. McCann cutting back behind the goal. Up the wall, Matheson will come back and take it at center ice. 50 seconds left of 4-on-4. Islanders racing for a change as Marino comes back in. They score! Islanders get caught in the change as Jared McCann makes it 2-0.
Harley Coyle can't get it through Matheson's skates. The next layer is CeCe. And Angelo sends Matheson ahead. The defenseman on the rush. And he scores! Mike Matheson! The BC product makes it 2-0 Pittsburgh.
It was fast. It was straight ahead. It was powerful. And Lezon just doesn't have a chance here. And McAvoy can't close. You know, we saw this on the McLeod goal the other night against New Jersey, where it's just speed to the outside. Grzelcyk was caught a little flat-footed on a bad bounce.
Gets an extra two. The Penguins' second power play of the game. Marino moving with the puck. Jason Zucker. Down low, Crosby, and they score! Rodriguez off the feed. It was Zahorna, not Crosby, on the feed.
Zahorna was there. Look at him, 67.
Yeah.
Wins it back. Beats Zibanejad. And then they go to work. Move the puck around. Zahora, beautiful little pass. And Rodriguez, who had a lot of chances in the game the other night.
Out of the zone here by Rust. Sealed off by Subban. He got knocked to the ice. Crosby, though, able to bank it back. Marino holds the zone behind the net. Gensel to the circle. A shot. They score. Crosby with the feed from Gensel to extend the lead.
He's not going to miss very often. Big collision from Subban and Rust, but the Penguins are able to get to that puck behind the net. They get it down low and kind of a one-touch heads-up play by Gensel. He sees Crosby going right to the slot. Look at that wrist shot. You see how he kind of puts that hand.
And Hughes with the intercept nearly given away as it's corralled by Severson. Now Gensel's on the puck. Shot by Crosby and stopped by Blackwood. Letang across. Here's Rust again with a wrist shot. They score! Brian Rust beats Blackwood and the Penguins extend the lead.
Well, the Devils were out there a bit. There's a good save off Crosby. He's so effective there. He just tries to get rid of it quick, but Rust too open there. And man, he continually just fires the puck and he gets a lot on this. Just want to see guys on him quicker. Maybe they checking for goalie interference possibly. I don't know. We'd have to look at it again, Kanch. Or is it something else?
For a great deal today.
Well, boy, that's... It's tough to speculate.
After coach's challenge review, it is determined that call in the ice stands. We have a good goal. New Jersey has been assessed a two-minute minor for delay of game.
Sidney Crosby. All the way across for Letang. 20 seconds on the power play. Here comes Letang. Now Gensel around the clock. Hits Crosby. And they score! Brian Rust out in front. Beautiful setup by Sidney Crosby. Power play goal and Pittsburgh has a 3-1 lead.
Getting guys to the net. It's moving the puck properly. It's deception. It's Sidney Crosby laying out in the weeds. It's all kinds of things. And look at the stick being presented by Brian Rust. Crosby's not shooting this puck. He sees Rust's stick. Who's got body position on Matt Irwin. Look at Crosby, he's just gonna look at the stick. That is a spectacular pass through a maze of players and stick, and Brian Rust strong on his lower hand. He's just gonna chip it.
Contained by Dumoulin, flicks it in deep for Crosby. Rust, broken stick. But then the follow-up, Crosby off the post. And now play, it's a goal. The whistle had sounded, Letang blasted it in.
Now the referee in the corner pointed goal right away. And there it is.
Softly off the board, Matt Tennyson. You give credit for the Devils' goal, first in 5.5 years in the NHL.
Didn't the Penguins just play against the goalie that got his Tokarski? Remember you were talking about
him? Oh, that's right,
him?
Yeah. Another guy bounced around.
Oh!
Cody Ceci shoots and scores! And the Pens get the lead back.
Full game. And they're going to do it again as they get it back to CeCe. You're going to have players get in front. This time, Zach Aston-Reese. He gets right in front of the shot. It goes by. The goaltender, Dell, still looking for it. He knows it's coming. Look at this. Look at all the traffic. Dell, he can't find the puck. Look at him. He's still looking.
Another guy, one goal shy of his total from last year. Set up to CeCe. Shot. Tip score. The Penguins lead at 3-0. Brian Rust.
Right on the top of the crease. Blackwood couldn't see anything. There's one that's deflected once and twice. Talk about a carom. Bingo. Gensel. Is that Gensel then, Rust? Is that Gensel's stick? Gensel's stick hits everything. Gensel is unbelievable. Look at this. Deflection. Gensel.
Crosby, it looked like a play that maybe most people wouldn't have tried, but he was anticipating swimming going down, no dice there.
Now Jeff Carter gets a pick out to him. Gensel, he scores!
But they like to play down low and in tight spaces, and this is a good example of it. Winning board battles, play down low, nice little two-on-one here. Crosby's able to find Gensel, and he's not wide open. I mean, there's not a lot of space there. Riley's right on top of him, but the quickness with which Gensel gets that puck off his...
Back the other way. Schultz, Backstrom, Mantha, 3-on-2. Baxter feeds, Mantha fires! Wonderful stop by Jari. 2-on-1 developing. Gensel feeds, McCann over his tape. 3-on-3, sudden victory overtime. Marino down low! Getsu! Gensel wins it for Pittsburgh.
Beautiful passing sequence by the Pittsburgh Penguins. Starts at the point, a good look by the defenseman, getting it down low to Gensel. And he just doesn't miss.
This one's hard to remember, but the last overtime regular season victory for Washington over Pittsburgh, October of 2011.
Wow, I can't remember that far back.
Pittsburgh wins them just about each and every time after regulation, and they do it tonight thanks to Getzel.
And what a play by Marino. A lot of D would just tee that up looking for the goal themselves. He saw the man off the side of the net.
Hathaway along the wall just squirts past him. Orlov, he's been so offensive-minded, gets rubbed out quickly by Dumoulin.
I love Orlov's game because he's skating. Every shift he's been on the ice, he's been skating.
Hathaway locks his balance. Rust is in alone. Rust fires. He scores.
Bad break by Hathaway. Blew a wheel right at the Capitals bench and tried to snap his stick over the crossbar at the end of that play. Here's the play just wrapped around. Schultz tries to give it back to Hathaway, and he just toe-picked. And now there's two Penguins going for the puck, and it's Rust who's got a step on Crosby, and he fires it quickly, Joe, right under the glove of Samsonov. The Pittsburgh Penguins have a 1-0 lead early here.
Back to break it up. Oh, and then a turnover, and Sanheim gave it away to Kapanen. But I'm able to come back and knock it away. But then Giroux is stripped. Malkin down low. Zucker scores. Jason Zucker in tight. Beats Elliott. It's 4-2 Pittsburgh as they take advantage of a Claude Giroux turnover.
Claude Giroux finds that puck. Stole it first and then had it checked back by the Penguins. Wasn't really a turnover either. It was just a good defensive play by Kapanen on the check back, and then Malkin feeds Zucker.
Disrupts this play and recovers the puck, drops it off. McCann down the middle, fires, he scores! A bullet, Jared McCann, 5-3 for the Pens.
For that blocker side, there's the turnover on the back check by Goudreau again, making the play here. And just a rip of a shot. Unbelievably great shot there. Don Granato did not even look at the backup here tonight.
Here for a while, realizing that Malkin will go to the bench now. Zucker trying to do the same thing. Anders Bjork cops it up. Here's a centering pass, a chance, score! Guess who? Jeff Carter! 490 to 399. He's got the opening tally here today.
Again, and Carter's all smiles, and why shouldn't he be? York tries to go back. Goudreau steals the puck, and that was kind of fanned on by Carter. Take a look. Stick's there. I don't even know if he got his stick on it. It went off his crest and in. Take a look. Goudreau, there's the pass. It was deflected by Bjork right into...